Hello everyone, here I will give detailed explanations on 2020 CSAT maths questions based on question paper series C. Let us begin with question number 8. Two statements S1 and S2 are given below with regard to four numbers P, Q, R and S, followed by a question. Statement 1, R is greater than P as well as Q. Statement 2, S is not the largest one. Then question, among four numbers P, Q, R and S, which one is largest? Then, which one of the following is correct in respect of the above statements and the question? So here we have to find which all statements are required to answer this question. So let us see the first statement. R is greater than P, Q. So from the first statement, we cannot say which one is largest, because there is one more number S. We don't know whether the S is largest or not. Then see the second statement. S is not the largest one. S is not the largest one. Among these three, R is the largest. Then it is said that among all these four, S is not the largest one. That means R is the largest one. So to answer this question, both statement 1 and statements 2 are required. So our answer is S1 and S2 together are sufficient to answer the question, but neither S1 alone nor S2 alone is sufficient. Two statements S1 and S2 are given below, followed by a question. S1. N is a prime number. Statement 2, N leaves a remainder of 1 when divided by 4. Then question, if N is a unique natural number between 10 to 20, then what is N? So, just like earlier question, which one of the following is correct in respect of the above statements and the question? We have to find which all statements are required to answer this question. So, first statement, N is a prime number. Then second statement, N leaves a remainder of 1 when divided by 4. So, between 10 to 20, how many such numbers are there? Between 10 to 20, prime numbers are 11, then 13, then 17, then 19. So these are the prime number between 10 and 20. So from the first statement, we got this much. Then N leaves a remainder of 1 when divided by 4. So here we can see 13 divided by 4, we get remainder 1. And similarly, 17 divided by 4, we get remainder 1. And here we get remainder equal to 3, 11 by 4. Here also we get remainder 3. So there are two numbers which satisfying the second statement. So we cannot find the, there are two values for this N. But here it is saying N is a unique natural number. So we have to find that unique number that we could not find with these two statements. So our answer is S1 and S2 together are not sufficient to answer this question. Question number 10. Two statements S1 and S2 are given below with regard to two numbers followed by a question. Statement 1. Their product is 21. Statement 2. Their sum is 10. Then question. What are the two numbers? So just like earlier question, which one of the following is correct in respect of the above statements and the question? S1 alone, here we have four options. So we have to find which all these statements are required to answer this question. First statement, their product is 21. So that X and Y, suppose X and Y are those two numbers, their product is 21. So here x and y can take infinite number of values. So from the first statement, we cannot find what is the value of x and what is the value of y. Then second statement, their sum is 10. X plus y equal to 10. So by simplifying these two equations, we can find x1 and x2. Those are unique values for x and y. So we can say S1 and S2 together are sufficient to answer the question, but neither S1 alone nor S2 alone is sufficient to answer this question. Option C is our answer. Question number 17. How many zeros are there at the end of the following product? While multiplying with 60, there will be 10, 50, 40, 30, 20, 10. All these numbers give 1 zeros each. So total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total 6 zeros will be there. Then while multiplying with 2 into 5, we get 10. So this also give zeros in the product. So how many such numbers are there in this numbers? Let us find. 20, we can write it as 2 into 10. Then 2 into this 15, we get 30. So 1 more 0. Then 40, we can write it as 2 into 10. This 10 already counted. Here also, this 10 also already counted. Then 2 into 35, 70. 2 into 45, 90. Then 60, we can write it as 2 into 3 into 10. So 2 into 55, 110, give 1 more 0. So total number of zeros in the product of these numbers equal to 6 plus 4, 10. Our answer is option A, 10. Question number 18. Let x, y, z be a 3-digit number where x plus y plus z is not a multiple of 3. Then x, y, z plus y, z, x plus z, x, y is not divisible by. So here x, y, z is a 3-digit number. It's a 3-digit number. So a 3-digit number, we can write it as x, y, z. Do 100x plus 10y plus z. Let us take another example, 123. To make it more clear, 123, we can write it as 1 into 100. Plus 2 into 10 plus 3. The same way we wrote xyz as 100x plus 10y plus z. Here we get some 1 into 100, 100 plus 20 plus 3, we get 123. That way we can write xyz as 100x plus 10y plus z. Then yzx equal to 100y plus 100y plus 10z plus x zxy equal to 100z plus 10x plus y. By adding all these three, we get x plus xyz plus yzx plus zxy. By adding all these three, we get 100x plus x plus 10x, total 111x plus 10y plus 100y plus y, we get 111y plus 111z. Then take 111 outside. Z. So we get xyz, yzx, zxy equal to 111 into x plus y plus z. So let's see whether first option is divided by this sum or not. 3 is divided by this. X plus y plus z is not divided by 3, not exactly divided by 3. Then 111 divided by 3 equal to, in 11 there are 3, then 21, 7, 37, we get 37. So 111 we can write it as 3 into 37. X plus y plus z. So this sum is divisible by 3, divisible by 37, and also divisible by x plus y plus z. So question was this is not divisible by, so our answer is B. Question number 19. Let P, Q, R and S be natural numbers such that P minus 2016 equal to Q plus 2017 equal to R minus 2018 equal to S plus 2019. Which one of the following is the largest natural number? So to compare this, first consider first two terms. P minus 2016 equal to Q plus 2017. Then rearranging this, Q plus 2017, I'm taking this 2016 into the other side, right side, then it become plus 2016. That means adding this much to this Q, it become equal to P. From here we can say P is greater than Q. Now let us consider the first and third term, P minus 2016 equal to R minus 2018. Then R equal to P minus 2016 plus 2018. 2018 minus 2016, we get plus 2. R is equal to P plus 2. Adding 2 to the P, we get R. That means R is greater than P. And P is, we already got P is greater than Q. Now let us compare the first and last term. Last term, S plus 2019. P minus 2016 equal to here S plus 2019. Then P equal to S plus 2019 plus 2016. Adding this much to S, we get P. That means P is greater than S. So P also greater than S. So we have to find the largest. Largest is R. The largest natural number among this is R. Our answer is option C. Question number 20. How many 5-digit prime numbers can be obtained by using all the digits 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 without repetition of digits? By using all the 5 digits without repetition. So how many prime numbers can be obtained? So what is mean by a prime number? A prime number is a number which we can't represent as a multiple of two natural numbers, smaller natural number other than 1 and itself. So consider one example, 17. 17 we can write it as only a product of 1 and 17. We can't make this 17 as a product of any smaller natural number other than this 1 and 17. So that is a prime number. Now let us make one number with these 5 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whether it is a prime number or not, just add all these numbers, we get 1 plus 2, 3, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. By adding all these numbers, we get 15. In any number, if some of its digits are a multiple of 3, then it is divisible by 3. That means whatever number we are making with these 5 numbers, it will be divisible by 3. So 3 is a product of 3 is a factor of any number we are making with these 5 numbers. So we cannot make a prime number using these 5 digits. So our answer is option A, 0. Question number 21. A man walks down the back side of his house straight 25 meters, then turns to the right and walks 50 meters again. Then he turns towards left and walks 25 meters. If his house faces to east, what is his direction from the starting point? So it is a problem on direction. So first we draw the directions: south, north, east, west. So his house is facing east, then back side of his house facing west. Then from back side, he started moving straight 25 meters. Then turn right and walks 50 meters. Then turns left and walks 25 meters. Then his direction from the starting point. This is the starting point, and now he is here. From the starting point, his direction is this. This is northwest. So he is at the northwest direction from his starting point. Our answer is option D. Question number 22. Two statements are given and followed by two conclusions. Statements: all numbers are divisible by 2. All numbers are divisible by 3. Conclusion 1: all numbers are divisible by 6. All numbers are divisible by 4. Conclusion 2. Then which of the following conclusions logically follows or follow from the two given statements? Then here said that a set of numbers, all these numbers are divisible by 2, and also all these numbers are divisible by 3. That means all these numbers are multiple of its least common multiple. So what is the LCM of these two numbers, 2 and 3? It is 6. All these numbers are a multiple of 6. All these numbers are a multiple of 6. Then see first conclusion. All numbers are divisible by 6. Yes, all these numbers are multiple of 6. So all these numbers are divisible by 6. Conclusion 1 is true. Then conclusion 2. All numbers are divisible by 4. Take one example, 6 itself. 6 is not exactly divisible by 4. So conclusion 2 is not following. So our answer is only conclusion one is true. Option. Question number 23. Two statements are given and followed by two conclusions. Statement 1, all cats are dogs. Then statement 2, all cats are black. Then conclusions. First one, all dogs are black. Second one, some dogs are not black. Which of the above conclusions logically follow or follows from the two given statements disregarding commonly known facts? That means here we have to take the given statements literally. All cats are dogs. So first one is all cats are dogs. So whatever cats are there, all these are dogs. Then all cats are black. All these cats are black. Then first conclusion is all dogs are black. All dogs are black. So here we have two chances. Suppose number of cats equal to number of dogs. Then this conclusion is true. All dogs are black because all cats are black. Then another thing is number of dogs is more than that of cat. Then we cannot make this conclusion because only those dogs which are cats are black. So first conclusion is not following. Now let us see the second conclusion. Some dogs are not black. If number of cats equal to number of dogs, odd cats are black, that means all dogs are also black. Then we can't say some dogs are not black. Then in case if number of dogs are more than that of cats, then only those black cats which are black are dogs. So some dogs are not black, we can say. So conclusion 2 also not following. Our answer is neither conclusion 1 nor conclusion 2 is following the statements. Question number 24. Consider the following sequence of numbers. How many odd numbers are followed by the odd number in the above sequence? How many odd numbers are followed by odd number? So first here, first number 5, which is followed by 1. So that is the first number we are looking for. Then 7, 3. 7 is followed by 3. Then second one. 3 is followed by 9. Third one. Then here it is 4th. Then here 3 followed by 1. It is 5th. Then 1 followed by 5. 6th. Then here only one odd number followed by even number. Here odd number followed by even number. Here also odd number followed by even number. So number of odd numbers followed by the odd number in the above sequence equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Our answer is option B. Question number 25. A is 16th from the left end in a row of boys, and V is 18th from the right end. G is 11th from A towards the right and 3 from V towards the right end. How many boys are there in the row? So this is the left end. This is the right end. From left end, A's rank is 16. Or A is sitting on 16th bench. Then from right end, V is sitting on 18th. Then it is said that G is 11th from A and 3rd from V towards right end. That means here it is G is 11 from A and 3 from V. Then we can see, including this V, V plus these three people up to G. V plus these three up to G. There are four people. Just deduct this 4 from 18. Then we get there are 14 people. 14 boys after G. Then total number of boys in the row equal to from left hand up to A, it is 16. Then A to G, there are 11. Then G to right hand, there are 14. Which is equal to 16 plus 11, 27. 27 plus 14, we get 41. Our answer is option B, 41. Question number 26. Three statements S1, S2 and S3 are given below, followed by a question. Statement 1. C is younger than D but older than A and B. Statement 2. D is the oldest. Statement 3. A is older than B. Question. Who among A, B, C and D is youngest? Which one of the following is correct in respect of the above statements and the question? Here first statement, C is younger than D but older than A and B. C is younger than D but older than A and B. So from here we cannot say which one is youngest. It might be either A or B. Then third statement, A is older than B. That means A is older than B. From here we can say B is the youngest. So statement 1 and 3 is sufficient to answer the question. Our answer is option. Question number 27. How many integers are there between 1 and 100 which have 4 as a digit but are not divisible by 4? So between 1 and 100, these are the integers which have 4 as a number. So first one, 4, 14, 24, 34, 44, 54, 64, 74, 84, 94. Then 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49. We know 4 is divisible by 4. Then 14 is not divisible by 4. So 1, 24 is divisible by 4. 34 is not divisible by 4. 54 not divisible by 4, 74 not divisible by 4, 94, then here 41, 42, 43, 45, 46, 47, then 49. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There are 12 numbers which have 4 as a digit but are not divisible by 4 between 1 and 100. Answer is option C, 12. Question number 28. Let x, y be the volumes, m, n be the masses of two metallic cubes P and Q respectively. Each side of Q is 2 times that of P and mass of Q is 2 times that of P. Let U equal to m by x and V equal to n by y. Which one of the following is correct? So here there are two metallic blocks P and Q. Their volumes x, volume of P equal to x and volume of Q equal to y. Then mass of P equal to m and mass of Q equal to n. Then it is said that each side of Q is 2 times that of P. Suppose side of P equal to A, then side of Q equal to 2a. Then volume of P equal to x, which is equal to a cube. Here volume of Q equal to 2a whole cube, which is equal to 8a cube. Then it is said that mass of Q is 2 times that of P. mass of P equal to m, then mass of Q equal to 2 times that of P, therefore it is 2m. Then let U equal to m by x and V equal to n by y, which of the following is correct? So here we got all the values. Now let us find what is U. U equal to m by x, m is mass of P, and x is volume of P, then V equal to n by y, n is mass of Q, which is equal to 2 times mass of P, and y is volume of Q, which is equal to 8a cube. Then U by y equal to U by V equal to m by a cube divided by 2m by 8 a cube. After simplifying this, m by a cube into 8 a cube divided by 2m. This mm gone, a cube gone. Then 8 by 2 equal to 4. So we got U by V equal to 4. That means U by V equal to 4. U equal to 4V. Our answer is option A, U equal to 4V. Question number 29. The average age of teacher and 3 students is 20 years. If all the 3 students are of same age and the difference between the age of teacher and each student is 20 years, then what is the age of the teacher? So average age of a teacher and 3 students is 20 years. How we find average? Average equal to total number of people. I am taking age of teacher as T and age of each student as S. Here it is given that 3 students are of same age. So I am taking age of each student as S. Then T plus 3 is divided by total number of people 4 equal to, that we get, we will give average, which is equal to 20 years. It is given here. Then by rearranging this, we get T plus 3s equal to, I am taking this 4 into right side, then it becomes 4 into 20 equal to 80. This is equation 1. Then it is said that the difference between age of teacher and each student is 20 years. T minus S equal to 20. This is equation 2. So we got 2 equations and 2 unknown, T and S. By simplifying this, solving this 2 equations, we get our required answer. So 1 minus 2, equation 1 minus 2, we get T minus T 0, 3S minus minus S, we get plus 4S, 80 minus 20, 60. From here, S equal to 60 divided by 4, we get 15. Then putting value of s in equation 2, t minus s equal to 20, we get, put value of s in equation 2, then t minus s equal to 20, t equal to 20 plus s, we know s equal to 15, so t equal to 20 plus 15, we get 35. So our answer is option C, age of teacher equal to 35 years. Question number 30. A person bought a car and sold it for rupees 3 lakhs. If he incurred a loss of 20%, then how much did he spend to buy the car? So the money he spent to buy the car, let us take it as X. Then it is said that he incurred a loss of 20% while selling this car. That means he incurred 20%, we can write it as 20 by 100 into X. This much loss, and he got 3 lakh rupees. 1. Then what is the value of this X? That is what we have to find. So X minus 20 by 100, we can write it as 0.2X equal to 3 lakhs. X minus 0.2x equal to 0.8x. Then x equal to 3 lakhs divided by 0.8. This we get 375,000. 375,000. He bought the car for 375,000. And our answer is option D, 375,000. Question number 31. In the sum given here, for which digit does the symbol at stand? So here we can see in the aggregate of these numbers, at units place of this aggregate, it is at. That means summing all the digits at units place of these numbers, the aggregates of these units place should be, there should be at its units place. This symbol should also there at its units place. Then only we get this as the sum. So let us add all the digits at units place of these numbers. At plus at plus at plus at, 4 at plus 1. This is equal to, at units place it should be at. Now let us put first option at the place of this symbol. Then 4 into 2 equal to 8 plus 1. 8 plus 1 we get 9. This is not equal to 2. Therefore 2 is not our answer. Then let us put 3 at the place of at. Then 4 into 3, 12. 12 plus 1 equal to 13. 3 equal to, here we've taken symbol value equal to 3. So here also we got 3. That means this can be our answer. Then 4 into 4, 16 plus 1, we got 17. 7, this is not equal to what the value we chosen for this at symbol 4. So this is not also our answer. Then finally, 4 into 5, 20 plus 1, 21. Here we should get 5, but it is 1. So this is also not our answer. So the answer is option B, 3. Question number 32. If you have two straight sticks of length 7.5 feet and 3.25 feet, what is the minimum length can you measure? By seeing these options, we can eliminate option A. It is not possible to measure 0.05 foot using these two sticks. Now let us take measurement using largest stick once. So it is 7.5 feet and 3.25 feet stick twice. Then 2 into 3.25 we get 6.5. So the difference between these two measurements we get 1 foot. That means we can eliminate option D also. Now let us take measurement using largest stick thrice. And smaller stick 7 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then 3 into 7.5 we get 22.5. Here 7 into 3.25 we get 22.75. Difference between these two measurements we get 0.25 foot. So the smallest length that we can measure using these two sticks is 0.25 foot. Our answer is option B, 0.25 foot. Question number 33. A simple mathematical operation. In each number of the sequence 14, 18, 20, 24, 30, 32 results in a sequence with respect to prime numbers. Which one of the following is the next number in the sequence? So here, these numbers have a relationship with prime number. So first we have to find that relationship. Then based on that we can find the next number. So here we can see 14 minus 1, 13. It's a prime number. 18 minus 1, 17 is a prime number. 20 minus 1, 19 is a prime number. 24 minus 1, 23 is a prime number. 30 minus 1, 29 is a prime number. 32 minus 1, 31 is a prime number. So, what is the next prime number in this sequence? After 31, next prime number is? Not 32, 33 is not a prime number, 34 not as a prime number, 35 not a prime number, then 37. So 37 plus 1 we get 38. So next number in the sequence is 38. Our answer is option C, 38. Question number 34. One page is torn from a booklet whose pages are numbered in the usual manner, starting from the first page as 1. The sum of the numbers on the remaining pages is 195. The torn page contains which of the following numbers? So we number pages 1, 2, 3, 4. If there are n pages, the nth page will number n. Then these are n natural number. Sum of n natural numbers equal to n into n plus 1 divided by 2. Then it should be approximately equal to 195. Adding some of these options, we get the original value of the sum n natural numbers. Here it is 5 plus 6 11, 7 plus 8 15, then 9 plus 10 19, and 11 plus 12 23. Just put values for n. Let us put n equal to 10. 10 into 10 plus 1 11 divided by 2 equal to 5 into 11 55. It is not nearer to this 195, so 10 is not our, the 10 is not the page number. Now let us put 20. 20 into 21 divided by 2. 20 into 21 divided by 2 equal to 10 into 21, 210. It is nearer to this 195. Now let us see. The difference between these two is matching with our options. 210 minus 195, we get 15. 15 is here, option B. It is matching with option B. So our answer is option B, 7,8. Question number 35. Considering the following arrangement that has some missing letters. The missing letters which complete the arrangement are: break this sequence into group of 5. Then it becomes AB, AB dash, B dash, BC, B, dash, D, CD, C, DE, DE dash, D. So fill this AB, AB, A, BC, BC, B, CD, CD, C, DE, DE, D. So our answer is option C. A, C, A, C, C, and E. Option C. Question number 36. Let A3BC and DE2F be 4-digit numbers where each letter represents a different digit greater than 3. If the sum of the numbers is 15902, then what is the difference between the values of A and D? So here, there are two 4-digit numbers A3BC, DE2F. Their sum equal to 15902. Then it is given that ABCDEF, all these are single-digit numbers greater than 3. Now let us see here. Let us see here. C plus F equal to, here we have to get 2. So what are the values possible for C and F? C equal to 4, F equal to 8, then C equal to 5, F equal to 7. 4 plus 8, we get 12. Then these are the only possible values for C and F. First, put C equal to 4 and F equal to 8. Then we get C plus F equal to 12. Then there will be remainder 1. Adding with this 2, 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus B's value, we should get 10. So what is the value of B? B equal to 7. Then 7 plus 2, here we got 10. Then here there will be a remainder 1. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus some value we get 9. So what is that value? It should be 5. Then the remaining two numbers are 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. A equal to 6 and D equal to 9. Their difference is 9 minus 6 equal to 3. Now let us put value of C equal to 5 and F equal to 7. 5 plus 7 equal to 12. Then the remainder is 1. Then 1 plus 2. 3, again we have to give b equal to 7. So here we have to use different values for each alphabet. But if you are using 5 and 7 for C and F, we have to use B also equal to 7. So the answer is A equal to 6 and D equal to 9. Their difference is 3. Option C, 3 is our answer. Question number 37. Two statements S1 and S2 are given below, followed by a question. Statement 1. There are not more than two figures on any page of a 51-page book. Statement 2. There is at least one figure on every page. Question. Are there more than 100 figures in that book? Which one of the following is correct in respect of the above statements and question? So here we have to see which of statements are required to answer this question. Are there more than 100 figures in that book? So let us see the first statement. There are not more than two figures on any page of a 51-page book. That means maximum number of figures in any page of that book equal to 2. Then there can be one figure page also, zero figure page also. If there are two figures in each page, then maximum possible equal to 102. If there are some pages, if there all pages have only one figure, then maximum possible figures equal to 51 into 151. So we cannot say there are more than 100 figures in that book. Any value less than 102 is possible. Now let us see the second statement. There is at least one figure on every page. That means at least one figure, there can be two figure also in each page. If there are one figure in each page, then maximum possible number of pages equal to, in that book equal to 1 into 51. If there are two figures in each page, then maximum possible equal to 102. So we cannot say how many pages are there, how many figures are there in that book by using any of this statement. So our answer is S1 and S2 together are not sufficient to answer the question. Option C. Question number 38. Considering the following data given here, what is the value of X in the above table? So here, overall average marks in English is given as 8.8 and overall average marks in Hindi equal to X. So here we have to find this X. So how we can find overall average marks in English? How we got this 8.8? This we got by overall average marks in English equal to average marks of girls in English into number of girls in class. Let us take it as G. Then 9 into G, we get total marks obtained by the girls in that class in English, plus average marks of boys in English into number of boys in the class. Let us take number of boys in the class equal to B. Then 8B, we get total marks obtained by the boys in English in that class. Then total number of students in that class, G plus B, we get average marks 8.8. 9G plus 8B, all divided by G plus B, we get 8.8 overall average marks. Similarly, overall average mark in Hindi equal to 8G plus 7B divided by total number of students in that class. This is equal to X. We have to find this X. Then, this is the overall average marks in English. This we can rewrite it as
8G plus 7B plus G plus B, then 8G plus G, it is 9G, and 7B plus B, it is 8B. All divided by G plus B, we get 8.8. This we can write it as 8G plus 7B divided by G plus B plus G plus B divided by G plus B. This is equal to 8.8. Then we know 8G plus 7B whole divided by G plus B equal to X. This is equal to X. Then X plus G plus B whole divided by G plus B equal to 1, equal to 8.8. Then X equal to 8.8 minus 1. I am taking this 1 to right side, then it become minus 1. Then answer is 7.8. Value of X equal to overall average marks in Hindi, which is equal to 7.8. Option A is our answer. Question number 39. A family of two generations consisting of 6 members, P, Q, R, S, T and U, has 3 males and 3 females. There are 2 married couples and 2 unmarried siblings. U is P's daughter and Q is R's mother-in-law. T is an unmarried male and S is a male. Which one of the following is correct? So, in a family, there are 6 members, P, Q, R, S, T, U, in 2 generations. First generation, second generation, and there are 3 males and 3 females. There are 2 married couples and 2 unmarried siblings. Then U is P's daughter. U is P's daughter. I am marking female member in a circle. Then P's daughter. P is in first generation and U is in second generation. And generation I am marking in a vertical line. Then Q is R's mother-in-law. That means Q is in first generation. She is a female member, so encircled it. Then R is in first generation, second generation. So here Q is a female member, U also a female member. Then T is an unmarried male. T is an unmarried male. And S is a male. I am marking S in a male in a square. Now here it is said that there are 2 married couples. So here R is a married person and Q also a married person and P also a married person. In first generation, both P and Q are married person. There is only 2 married couples. That means P married to Q. Q is a female member. That means P is husband of Q. P is a male member. Then the only remaining R also a male member. So here we can encircle it. Now we have to find a husband for R. Here P already assigned. S is a male and T is an unmarried male. So the only option is S. Here we can write S. And R is mother-in-law of Q. That means S is Q's son. Then there are 2 unmarried siblings. the remaining option T, sibling of this U. Now let us see the options. R is U's husband. No. R is S wife. R is, here it is, S is a male member. R is S wife. That is true. S is unmarried. No. None of the above. So our answer is option B. R is S wife. Question number 40. If in a particular year, 12th January is a Sunday, then which one of the following is correct? Option A, 15th July is a Sunday if the year is a leap year. So if today is Sunday, then after 7 days it will be again Sunday. By using this knowledge, we can solve this question. So here, 12th January is a Sunday. Then after 12th January, there are 31 minus 12, 19 days in that month. Then in February, if it is a leap year, there will be 29 days. In March, every March has 31 days. Every April has 30. Here it is 31. Here it is 30. Here it is 31. Here we have to find July 15th. July 15th. Sum all these, we get 185 divided by 7, we get 26 week and 3 days. At the end of this 26th week, it will be a Sunday again. But here, 3 more days. That means this Sunday will be this 15th July will be is a Wednesday. 15th July is a Wednesday. So this is not our answer. Then 15th July is a Sunday if the year is not a leap year. Not a leap year means February has 28 days. Then it becomes, sum become 184. Then here 26 weeks and 2 days. At the end of this 26th week, it will be a Sunday. So this is also not an answer. Not our answer. Then 12th July is a Sunday if the year is a leap year. Before that, we do the option D. 12th July is a Sunday if the year is not a leap year. So here, 12th July decreased by 3 days from here. Then this becomes 181. That means 25 week and 6 days. At the end of this 26th week, it will be a Sunday. But therefore, this is also not our answer. Then 12th July is a Sunday if the year is a leap year. So here it will be 29. This become 182. Then 182 divided by 7, we get exactly 26th week. That means at the end of this 26th week, it will be a Sunday again. Our answer is option C. 12th July is a Sunday if the year is a leap year. Question number 47. How many different five-letter words, with or without meaning, can be constructed using all the letters of the word Delhi, so that each word has to start with D and end with I? So here, we have to construct five-letter words using all the letters of the word Delhi. Delhi has 5 letters. That means, in these 5-letter words, letters are not repeating. Then it is said that each word has to start with D and end with I. Then that words should be like this. D at the start and I at the end. The remaining three letters in between. So ELH we can arrange in 3 factorial words. There are 3 words. 3 factorial equal to 3 into 2 is equal to 6. So we can arrange ELH in 6 ways. ELH, LEH, HLE, like that. So 6 ways we can arrange these 3 words. Then D at the start, I at the end, we can have 6 words. Our answer is option D, 6. Question number 48. A bottle contains 20 liters of liquid A. 4 liters of liquid A is taken out of it and replaced by same quantity of liquid B. Again, 4 liters of the mixture is taken out and replaced by same quantity of liquid B. What is the ratio of quantity of liquid A to that of liquid B in the final mixture? So here, there is liquid A and liquid B. Initially, there were only liquid A, 20 liters, and liquid B was 0 liter. Then, 4 liters of liquid A is taken out, then it becomes 16 liters, and 4 liters of liquid B is added. Then this is a new mixture, 16 plus 4. Then again 4 liters of this mixture is taken out. Then 16 minus liquid A will reduce by 4 into 16 by 20. 4 into 16 by 20. This much quantity will of liquid A will reduce. Here 4 minus 4 into 4 by 20. This much will reduce and 4 liters of liquid B is added to it. Then what is the ratio of liquid A to liquid B? So we have to find the ratio of liquid A to liquid B. Then after simplifying this, we will get the required answer. This is the quantity of liquid A taken out of that mixture. If you are taking 4 liters of this mixture, in that 4 liter, 4 into 16 by 20 will be the liquid A, and 4 into 4 by 20 will be the liquid B. Then ratio of liquid A and liquid B equal to 16 into, I am taking 16 outside, then it become 1 minus 4 by 20 equal to 1 by 5 whole divided by, I am taking 4 here also, here I am taking 4 outside, then 4 plus 4 8, then 2 minus 1 by 5. This is equal to 16 into 5 minus 1, 4, 4 by 5. Here 4 into 2 into 5, 10, 10 minus 1, 9, 9 divided by 5. Then simplifying this, we get 5, 5 gone, 4, 4 gone, this become 16 by 9, that is equal to 16 is to 9. Our answer is option C, 16 is to 9.
Question number 49. The average score of a batsman after his 50th innings was 46.4. After 60th innings, his average score increases by 2.6. What was his average score in the last 10 innings? So here it is given, average after 50th innings. So how we find average after 50th innings? Total runs he scored after 50th innings. Well, divided by 50, we get average score after 50th innings, which is equal to 46.4. Then it is said that after 60th innings, his average score increases by 2.6. After 60th innings, his average score increased by 2.6. Total runs after 60th innings divided by 60, we get average score after 60th innings, which is equal to 46.4 plus 2.6 equal to 49. Then it is said that, asked, what was his average score in the last 10 innings? So how we find the average score after last 10 innings? Total runs scored in the last 10 innings divided by 10, we get the average score in the last 10 innings. So for that, runs scored in the last 10 innings equal to total runs after 60th innings minus total runs after 50th innings. So how we find total runs after 60th innings? See here, total runs after 60th innings divided by 60, we get 49 as average. Takes this 60 into right side here, then it become 49 into 60. That is equal to total runs scored in the after 60th innings. That is equal to 60 into 49. Here it is, 60 into 49 minus total runs scored after 50th innings, which is equal to, take this 50 into right side, then it become 46.4 into 50. We get total runs after 50th innings. That's equal to 50 into 46.4. Then after simplifying this, we get total runs scored by him in the last 10 innings. All divided by 10, we get our required answer. 16 into 9, 54. 4 into 6, 24 plus 5, 29. 2320. We get 2320. 50 into 46.4 equal to 2320. This is equal to 620. So total runs scored in the last 10 innings equal to 620. Then average equal to average in the last 10 equal to last 10 innings equal to 620 divided by 10, we get 62. Our answer is option C, 62. Question number 50. As a result of 25% hike in the price of rice per kilogram, a person is able to purchase 6 kilogram less rice for rupees 1200. What was the original price of rice per kilogram? Let us take original price of rice per kilogram equal to X. Then he could purchase Y kilogram of rice for 1200 rupees. Then there happened 25% hike in the price of rice per kilogram. So how can we represent it? Earlier it was X, then 25% we can write it as 25 divided by 100. 25% of X is increased. Then it become 25 divided by 100 equal to 0.25. X plus 0.25 we get 1.25. This is the
new price of the rice, 1.25x per kilogram. Then he could purchase 6 kilogram less rice. Earlier price was new price is 1.25. Earlier he could purchase y kilogram, but with this price he could purchase 6 kilogram less for the same money. Then what is the, here we have to find what is the value of this x. Here we have two equations and two unknown x and y. So by solving this, we can find x. This is equation 1. This is equation 2. So here, equation 2 by 1, we get 1.25x into y minus 6 divided by x into y equal to 1200 divided by 1200. Then xx gone, here 1200 gone. Then 1.25 for easy simplification, 1.25 we can write it as 5 by 4. 5 by 4 equal to 1.25. y minus 6 divided by y. This is equal to 1. Then 5y minus 30. I multiplied, taking this 5 into inside, equal to 4y. 4y I am taking right side, 4y. Then we get y equal to 30. Y equal to 30 and xy equal to 1200. Put value of y in equation 1. X into 30 equal to 1200. X equal to 1200 divided by 30. We get 40 as our required answer. Option B, rupees 40 is our answer, the original price of rice per kilogram.
Question number 57. A shop owner offers the following discount options on an article to a customer. These are the three discount options given. Then which one of the following is correct? Here we have to find which of these discount option is good for the customer. To solve this question, let us take cost of article equal to 100. Then successive discount of 10% and 20%, and then pay a service tax of 10%. To find the 10% of any value, put a decimal one place after the from the right end. For example, 10% of 100 equal to, put a decimal point here, then 10% of 100 equal to 10. Therefore, after successive discount of 10%, so after 10% discount, 10% of 100 equal to 10, it become 90. Then after that, 20% discount. How we find 20% of 90? 10% of 90 equal to 9. Then 20% means 2 times of 10%. Then 2 into 9, 18. Minus 18, we get 72. Then pay a service tax of 10%. 10% of 72 equal to 7.2. So adding 7.2 with 72, we get price of that article based on first option equal to 72 plus 7.2. here we get 79.2. this is the cost of article based on first discount option. Now let us see the second option. 20% discount from the 100. 10% of 100 equal to 10. 2 into 10 equal to 20. So we get 20% of 100 equal to 20. 100 minus 20, 80. Then 10% of 80 equal to 8. We get 72. Then pay a service tax of 10%. 10% of 72 equal to 7.2. We get 79.2 is the cost of article based on the second discount option. So here, first option discount option and second discount option are equally good. Therefore, our answer is option D. All the options are equally good for the customer. Question number 58. The letters from A to Z are numbered from 1 to 26 respectively. If GHI equal to 1578, DEF equal to 912, then what is ABC equal to? So here first we have to find the relationship between these letters and their coded numbers. Then using the same relationship, we have to find what is the code for ABC. GHI equal to 1578. G H I. G H I. So what is the number for G? G equal to 7. 7 and H equal to H equal to 8, and I equal to 9. When it numbering from 1 to 26, then 7 into 2 equal to 14, 8 into 2 equal to 16, and 9 into 2 equal to 18. Adding all these, we get 8, 7, 5, 1, 1578. So we found the relationship between the letters and numbers. Similarly, DEF also, DEF, D equal to 4, E equal to 5, F equal to 6, 8, 10, 12. Adding all these numbers, 2, 1, 9. We get 912. The same way we can find ABC. ABC. A equal to 1, B equal to 2, C equal to 3. Then double these values. A equal to, then 1 into 2, 2, 2 into 2, 4, 2 into 3, 6. Then 246 is the code for ABC. Our answer is option D, 246. Question number 59. What is the missing term at in the following? Here, SEPQ coded with BESU. M and GI coded dash, we have to find that. So first we have to find the relationship between ACPQ and BESU. Then using the same relationship, we will find what is the code for M and GI. So ACPQ. ACPQ. The next letter after A in the English alphabet, it is B. Then C, D, E. Then P, Q, R, S. And here
R S T U. So ACPQ coded BESU. The same way we can code M N G I. Here N and O P G H I J. Here I J K L M. So we can code M N G I as NPJM. Our answer is option D, NPJM. JM. Question number 60. What is the largest number among the following? Here, first number is 1/2 power -6. This we can write as 1/-6 divided by 2/-6. Then, 1 power any number, we get 1 itself. 1/1, 1/2, 1/3, any number. 1 power any number, we get 1 itself. And 2/-6, we can write it as, when it comes to numerator, it become 2/6. Then 2/6 equal to 64. So value of first number is 64. Same way we can find the value of second number. 1/4 4/-3. This we can write as 4³. 4³ equal to 4 into 4 into 4. That is 64. This is also equal to, second term also equal to 64. Then third term, 1/3, 4/-4. This we can write as 3/4. 3/4 means 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. It become 81. It is 81. So C equal to 81. Then finally, one by 6/-2. This is equal to 1/6/-2 equal to 6² equal to 36. 1/6/-2 equal to 36. So the largest value among this equal to 81. It is option C, 1/3 4/-4. Our answer is option C. Question number 61. A person X can complete 20% of work in 8 days. Another person Y can complete 25% of the same work in 6 days. If they work together, how many days will 40% of the work be completed? So here, X can complete 20% of work in 8 days. So 20% of work we can write as 20/100 work. Then that is 20/100 equal to 1/5. X take 8 days to complete 1/5 work. Then it is said that Y take 25% of work, Y can complete 25% of work in 6 days. 25% of work we can write it as 25/100 work. That is equal to 1/4 work in 6 days. Then let us find the how much work each can do in one day. So in one day, X can complete, take this 8 left side, then 8 into 5, 40. 1/40 work.
in one day. And why can complete? Take this 6 left side, then it becomes divided by 4 into 6, 24. 1 by 24 work in one day. Then, how much work they can do together in one day? Together, X and Y, in one day. One by 40 work by X plus 1 by 24 work by Y. This much they can complete in one day. So take LCM 120. Here 3 into 40. Here 5 into 24. So 8 by 120. Eight by 120 equal to, there are 15. They can complete, they can, they together can complete 1 by 50th work in one day. Then how much days they will take to complete full work? Just take this 15 to left side, then in 15 days they can complete full work. So but here they are asked, In how many days will 40% of the work be completed? So 40% of the work, how much time it will take? So to complete one full work, they will take this 15 to left side, then it become multiplied by in 15 days. One full work, they will take 15 days. Then 40% of the work. 40% of the work we can write as 40 divided by 100. Work, they will take 40 divided by 100 into 15 days. Then 2 5s here it is 3 5, then 2 into 3, 6 days. They take 6 days to complete 40% of the work together. Our answer is 6 days. Option A is our answer. Question number 62. A car travels from a place X to a place Y at an average speed of V km per hour, from Y to X at an average speed of 2V km per hour, again X to Y at an average speed of 3V km per hour, and again from Y to X at an average speed of 4V km per hour. Then the average speed for the car for the entire journey. We can solve this question using the basic equation, speed equal to distance divided by time. Then time equal to distance divided by speed. Here it is said that car travels from a place X to Y at an average speed of V kilometer per hour. So first is the car travel from X to Y at an average speed of V kilometer per hour. Let us take the distance between X and Y equal to A. Then time taken for the first journey equal to A by V. Then for second journey, speed was 2V. Then T2 equal to A by 2V. Then for third journey, it was 3V. Time taken for that journey equal to A by 3V. Here it is 4V. T4 equal to A divided by 4V. Then we have to find the average speed for the car for the entire journey. So here, average speed of the car, V average equal to total distance traveled by the car, which is equal to A plus A plus A plus A, 4A. 4A divided by total time taken by the car to complete the entire journey, which is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus T4. Then 4A divided by T1 equal to A by V, T2 equal to A by 2V, then T3 equal to A by 3V, and T4 equal to A by 4V. After simplifying this, we get our required answer. Here, 4A divided by LCM of this V, 2V, 3V and 4V, which is equal to 12V. Then in numerator it is 12A plus 6A plus 4A plus 3A. Then this is equal to 4A divided by 12A plus 6A plus 4A plus 3A. We get 25A. 25A divided by 12V. This is equal to AA gone. Then this 12 comes in the upside. Then 4 into 12V, we get 48V. In the numerator, it is 48V. Then divided by 25. So average speed equal to 48 divided by 25V. This is equal to 1.9 something V. So our answer is the average speed for the car for the entire journey equal to journey is lies between V and 2V kilometer per hour. Our answer is option B. Question number 63. Consider the following statements. Statement 1. The minimum number of points of intersection of a square and a circle is 2. Statement 2. The maximum number of points of intersection of a square and a circle is 8. Which of the above statements is or are correct? Now let us see the first statement. Minimum number of points of intersection of a square and circle is 2. So a circle and a square even one point also possible point so one point of intersection also possible so this statement is wrong. Now see the second statement. The maximum number of points of intersection of a square and a circle is 8. Here I draw a circle, then a square, then number of intersections are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Maximum possible intersections, points of intersection of a square and circle equal to 8. Statement 2 is correct. Therefore, our answer is option B, 2 only. Question number 64. A man takes half time in rowing a certain distance downstream than upstream. What is the ratio of the speed in still water to the speed of current? Here, let us take speed of rower in still water equal to R and speed of current or stream equal to S. Then they are asked, what is the ratio of speed in still water, that is R, to the speed of current, S. R by S we have to find. This is what we have to find. Now let us solve this. A man takes half time in rowing certain distance downstream. Half time than upstream. So here, while rowing downstream, the relative speed is R plus speed in the still water plus speed of stream. This is equal to, let us take the distance in one direction equal to x divided by t by 2 time. This is equation 1. This is the relative speed in the downstream. Then relative speed in the upstream equal to R minus S equal to x by t. This is equation number 2. Solving these two equations, we will get value of R and S. Then R by S, we will get our required answer. So let us solve these two equations. R plus S equal to, let us take this 2 into numerator, then it becomes 2x divided by t. Then take this 2 to left side, then it becomes R plus S divided by 2 equal to x by t. Here R minus S equal to x by t. Equating these two equations, we get R plus S divided by 2 equal to R minus S. Then take this 2 to right side, this 2 to right side, then it become 2 into R minus S. Simplifying this, we get R plus S equal to 2 into R minus 2S. This is equal to, take this R right side and S left side, then it become 3S equal to R, then R by S equal to 3. Here we have to find the ratio of rowing speed in still water to the speed of current or speed of stream. That is equal to R is to S. We get 3 is to 1. Our answer is option D, 3 is to 1. Question number 65. How many pairs of natural numbers are there such that the difference of whose squares is 63? First, see the first pair. 1 square equal to 1. 8 square equal to 64. The difference between 64 and 1 equal to 63. Then second pair. 9 square equal to 81. 12 square equal to 144. The difference between 144 and 81 equal to 63. These two pairs are very easy to find because these are squares of smaller natural numbers. Then to find the third pair, you need to have some basic idea about these squares. I will explain that with one example. 2 square equal to 4,
3 square equal to 9. We can find this 3 square in this way. This is equal to 2 square plus this 2 plus 3. This 2 plus this 3. So we get 2 square equal to 4 plus 6 plus 3, 9. We get 9. The same way, 31 square equal to 961. Then 32 square equal to 961 plus 31 plus 32. So this is equal to 961 plus 63. 32 square equal to 1024. So the difference between 31 square and 32 square equal to 63. If you want to find the two numbers, a pair of numbers whose squares difference is 43, then 21 and 22 are such a pair. 21 square plus 22 square minus 21 square, you will get 43. So here our answer is, this is the third pair. Total there are three pairs. Our answer is option A, 3. Question number 66. Which one of the following will have minimum change in its value if 5 is added to both numerator and the denominator of the fractions 2 by 3, 3 by 4, 4 by 5 and 5 by 6? So here we have to find the minimum change when 5 is added to both numerator and denominator of the following fractions. So these fractions 2 by 3, 3 by 4, 4 by 5 are a sequence. In that, both numerator and denominator are added 1 in each subsequent numbers. Here 2 by 3 plus 2 plus 1 plus 3 plus 1, we get 3 by 4. Similarly, 3 plus 1 plus 4 plus 1, we get 4 by 5, like that. This is a sequence, infinite sequence. Now, let us write the, you know, this fractions in the form of decimal. Then 2 by 3 equal to 0.67, 3 by 4 equal to 0.75, 4 by 5 equal to 0.8. Like that, these numbers are increasing. And we can see these numbers are increasing in decreasing manner. Here, 2 by 3 to 3 by 4, the difference is 0.08. And 3 by 4 to 4 by 5, the difference is 0.05. And 4 by 5 to 5 by 6, it is 0.033. That means this increasing sequence, increasing value, the amount which increasing is decreasing. Here it is 0.08, 0.05, 0.0333. So when numerator and denominator added by 5, then 2 by 3 becomes 7 by 8. When 5 by 6 added to 5 in the numerator and denominator, it becomes 10 by 11. Here we can see the difference between 7 by 8 and 2 by 3 will be more than the difference between 5 by 6 and 10 by 11. Here you can see the changes is decreasing as it moves to rightward, as it is progressing. So here the sum will be maximum and here the sum will be minimum. Therefore, our answer is option D, 5 by 6. Which have the minimum change in its value if 5 is added to both numerator and denominator. Question number 67. A digit n greater than 3 is divisible by 3 but not divisible by 6. Which one of the following is divisible by 4? So here there are three conditions. N is a digit which is greater than 3, divisible by 3, not divisible by 6. Then value of N equal to 9, which is greater than 3, divisible by 3, not divisible by 6. Then which among the following options is satisfying this condition, that is divisible by 4? That will be our answer. Then 2 into n, first option, 2 into n, 2 into 9, this is equal to 18, which is not exactly divisible by 4, therefore option A is not our answer. Then third option, 2 into n plus 4, this is equal to 22, not exactly divisible by 4, therefore this is also not our answer. Then third option, 3 into 9 equal to 27, second option, so this is also not our answer. Then fourth option, 3 into 9 plus 1, this is equal to 28, this is exactly divisible by 4, we get 4 sevens are 28, so for this is our answer, option D, 3n plus 1.
Question number 68. If 1 liter of water weighs 1 kilogram, then how many cubic millimeters of water will weigh 0.1 gram? Here, 1 liter equal to 1 kilogram. 1 kilogram. Then they are asked, how many cubic millimeters of water will weigh 0.1 gram? So here we have to convert this 1 liter into cubic millimeters and kilogram to gram. So 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. Then convert 1 liter to cubic millimeters. 1 liter equal to 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube. Then 1 meter equal to 1000 millimeter. 1 meter equal to 1000 millimeter. So instead of this meter, write 1000 millimeter cube. Then 10 raised to minus 3 into 1000 cube equal to 10 raised to 9. Raised to plus 9, then 10 raised to minus 3 into 10 raised to 9 equal to 10 raised to 6. Here it is millimeter cube. That means 1 liter equal to 1 liter equal to 10 raised to 6 millimeter cube, which is equal to 1000 gram. But they are asked, how many cubic millimeters of water will weigh 0.1 gram? Here it is 0.1 gram. So 1 liter 10 raised to 6 millimeter cube equal to 1000 gram. Take this 1000 left side, then it become divided by 1000. That means 10 raised to 6 divided by 1000 equal to 1000. 1000 millimeter cube equal to 1 gram. Then here divide by 10, here also divided by 10. 1 by 10 equal to 0.1 gram. 0.1 gram equal to, this is what we have to find, 0.1 gram equal to 100 millimeter cube. Our answer is option C, 100. 0.1 gram equal to 100 millimeter cube or cubic millimeters.
Question number 69.
A vessel full of water weighs 40 kilogram. If it is one-third filled, its weight becomes 20 kilogram. What is the weight of the empty vessel? So here there is a vessel full of water weighs 40 kilogram. Both water plus container, this empty vessel weighs 40 kilogram. Then the same vessel, one-third filled with water, weighs 20 kilogram. Then we can say the difference between these two equal to two-third of water without vessel. Its weight equal to 20 kilogram. Then we have to find what is the weight of the empty vessel. So we have to find the weight of this empty vessel, which is equal to 2 by third of water equal to 20 kilogram. Then full water equal to, I'm taking this 3 right side, then it becomes 20 into 3. I'm taking this 2, this 2 to right side, then it becomes divided by 2. Simplifying this, we get 30 kilogram. Weight of full water equal to 30 kilogram. And weight of full water and container equal to 40 kilogram. Then difference between these two, 40 minus 30, we get the weight of container, which is equal to 10 kilogram. Our answer is option A, 10 kilogram. Question number 70. A frog tries to come out of dried well 4.5 meter deep with slippery walls. Every time the frog jumps 30 centimeter, slides down 15 centimeter. What is the number of jumps required for frog to come out of the well? So here, let us take number of jumps required for frog to come out of well equal to x. Then each time it jumps 30 centimeter and slides down 15 centimeter. If it jumps x times, then it slides down x into 15 times. This is equal to 4.5 meter, we can write it as 450 centimeter. When it reaches at the top in the last jump, it won't slides down. It already reaches at the top, it can just go out of the well. So here we have to deduct minus 1, because in the last jump it won't slides down. Then it becomes x minus 1 into 15. Solving this equation, we will get our required answer, number of jumps, which is equal to x. Let us solve this equation. X into 30, we can write it as 30x. X into 15x. Minus 1 into minus 15, here we get 15. This is equal to 450. Then 15x, 30x minus 15x, we get 15x equal to 450 minus 15. Plus 15, when it go to right side, it become minus 15. Then x equal to 450 minus 15, which is equal to 435 divided by 15. You get x equals 29. So our answer is option B, number of jumps required for frog to come out of the well equal to 29. Question number 71. What is the greatest length x such that 3 and 1 by 2 meter and 8 and 3 by 4 meter are integral multiples of x? So here 3 and 1 by 2, we can write it as 3 into 2 plus 1, we get 7.
divided by 2. Then 8 and 3 by 4 as 35 divided by 4. 18 to 4 equal to 32 plus 3, we get 35 divided by 4. Now, here we have to find which one of the following is, when multiplied with an integer, we get these two values. So, let us find that. We can write 1 and 1 by 2 as 1 into 2 plus 1, 3 by 2. 3 by 2, when multiplied with 2, we get 6 by 2. When multiplied with 3, we get 9 by 2. We are not getting this value when multiplied with any integer. Therefore, this is not our answer. Now, let us see the second option. 1 and 1 by 3, we can write it as 1 into 3 plus 1, 4 by 3. Here, the denominator is 3. Here it is 2. Here it is 4. Therefore, this also can't be our answer. Then, third option. 1 and 1 by 4. 1 and 1 by 4, we can write it as 1 into 4 plus 1, 5 by 4. When multiplied with 7, we get 35 divided by 4. But when multiplied with 2, we get 5 by 2. When multiplied with 4, we get 10 by 2. So, we are not getting this value when 5 by 4 multiplied with an integer. Therefore, this is also not our answer. Then, finally, our answer is option D, 1 and 3 by 4. 1 and 3 by 4, we can write it as 1 into 4 plus 3, 7 by 4. 7 by 4 multiplied with 2, we get 2 to serve 4, 7 by 2, we get this answer. Then, when multiplied with 5, we get 5 into 7, 35, 35 divided by 4, we get this value also. Therefore, option D, 1 and 3 by 4, when multiplied with an integer, we get these two values. Our answer is option D. Question number 72. Consider the following data. For which period was the natural growth rate maximum? So, what is mean by natural growth rate? Natural growth rate is the difference between birth rate and death rate. So, birth rate minus death rate. So, here we have to find birth rate minus death rate of all these values. Which among this is maximum? That will be our answer. So, here in 1971 to 1981, the difference is 37.1 minus 14.8, we get 22.3. This is the maximum value among all those values. Therefore, our answer is option D, 1971 to. Question number 73. The recurring decimal representation 1.272727 etc. up to infinity is equivalent to which of the following option? Let us solve the first option, 13 divided by 11. 13 divided by 11, we can write, find it as 1 into 11. Here, remainder 2 in 20. There are only 111. Therefore, this is not matching with this decimal representation. Therefore, this is not our answer. Then second option, 14 divided by 11. In 14, there is only 111. 1 into 11, 11. 14 divided by 11, we get 3. Then in 30, there are 211. 2 into 11 equal to 22. In then 30 minus 22, 8 in 80. There are 7, 11. 7 into 11, we get 77. Here again 30. In 30, there are 2, 11. 2 into 11, we get 22. Then 80. In 80, 7. So, the same thing is repeating here. 1.27, 27, 27. Again, we get 27, 27, 27. Therefore, our answer, this decimal is matching with, this value is matching with the given decimal value. Therefore, our answer is option B, 14 by.
Question number 73. The recurring decimal representation 1.27272727, etc. up to infinity is equivalent to which of the following option? Let us solve the first option, 13 divided by 11. 13 divided by 11, we can write, find it as 1 into 11. Here, remainder 2 in 20, there are only 111. Therefore, this is not matching with this decimal representation. Therefore, this is not our answer. Then second option, 14 divided by 11. In 14, there is only 111. 1 into 11, 11, 14 divided by 11, we get 3. Then in 30, there are 2, 11. 2 into 11, equal to 22. In then 30 minus 22, 8. In 80, there are 7, 11. 7 into 11, we get 77. Here again 30. In 30, there are 2, 11. 2 into 11, we get 22. Then 80, in 80, 7. So, the same thing is repeating here. 1.27, 27, 27. Again, we get 27, 27, 27. Therefore, our answer, this decimal is matching with, this value is matching with the given decimal value. Therefore, our answer is option B, 14 by 11.
Question number 74. What is the least 4-digit number when divided by 3, 4, 5 and 6 leaves a remainder 2 in each case? So here to find, we have to find the 4-digit number. For that, first we have to find the LCM of these 4 numbers. Then, which among these options, when divided by LCM, we get remainder as 2? That will be our answer. So first find LCM by prime factorization. Prime factorization we can do in this way, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then take the least prime, which is a factor of these 4 numbers. Then 2, 2 is a factor of 4 and 6. So it is not a factor of 3. 3 we keep as it is. Then 2 2s are 4. 5 was 2 also, 2 not a factor of 5, so we keep 5 as it is. And 3 2s are 6. Then here there are 2 3s, so just do prime factorization by 3. 1 2 5 1. Then all these are now prime. Then multiplying these values, we get the LCM, 2 into 3 into 2 into 5, we get 60 as LCM. Now, this is the LCM. Now, divide these 4 options with the LCM 60. First divide 1012 with 60. In 101 there is 160. Then here 412. In 420 there are 760s. 7 into 60 we get 420. 6 into 60 we get 360. So here the remainder will be 52. Therefore, first option is not our answer. Then second option 1022 divided by 60. We get here 422. 720s are while dividing 760s are 420. Then remainder we got 2. Therefore, option B 1022 is our answer. That is the four digit number when divided by 3, 4, 5, and 6 leaves a remainder 2 in each case. Here 1122 we won't get the remainder 2, and 1222 also, and these two numbers are more than this, therefore no need to check these two numbers.
Question number 75. In adult population of a city, 40% men and 30% women are married. What is the percentage of married adult population if no man marries more than one woman and no woman marries more than one man? And there are no widowers and widows. So here we have to find percentage of married adult population. Then it is said that no man marries more than one woman. So one man to one woman, and no woman marries more than one man here. Then one woman to one man. Then no widowers and widows. That means if there are 100 married adult men, there will be 100 married adult women. So here it is said that 40% men and 30% women are married. That means 40% men equal to 30% women. This many married men are there. So that many married women also there. 40% men, we can write it as 40 divided by 100, which is equal to 0.4 men. That is equal to 0.3 women. Then simplifying this, we get M equal to 3 by 4 women. Number of adult men in the city equal to 3 by 4 adult women in the city. Now let us find the married adult population. Percentage of married adult population. Total adult population in the city equal to total men plus total women. Married in that 0.3 women are married. And that many number of men also married. Into 100, we get the required answer. Here, we know number of men population in the city equal to, adult population in the city equal to 3 by 4 women. Just put M equal to 3 by 4 W. Then W, these are gone. Then simplifying this, we get required answer. 2 into 0.3.6 into 100 divided by 3 by 4 plus 1. Here in the denominator it is 3 by 4 plus 1. That is equal to 7 by 4. We get 60 into 4. 4 comes in the, this 4 comes in the numerator. 60 into 4, 240. Divided by 7, we get 34 and 2 by 7 percentage as the answer. Option C, 34 and 2 by 7 percentage is. Question number 76. What is the remainder when 51 into 27 into 35 into 62 into 75 is divided by 100? To find the remainder, first multiply the last digit of all these numbers. So 1 into 7 into 5 into 2 into 5, we get 350. That means at the end of this product, there is a 0. If there are 2 zeros in the product, then when dividing with 100, remainder will be 0. If there is only 1 0, then when dividing with 100, in the remainder also, there will be a 0. So in the given option, only option A has a 0 at the end. So our answer is option A, 50. Question number 77. A sum of rupees 2500 is distributed among X, Y and Z in the ratio 1 by 2 is to 3 by 4 is to 5 by 6. What is the difference between the maximum share and the minimum share? So here we have to distribute 2500 among X, Y and Z. Then let us take share of X equal to X, Y equal to Y and Z equal to Z. Then by dividing these numbers with a equal value M, then we get the ratios 1 by 2 is to 3 by 4 is to 5 by 6. That means share of X equal to 1 by 2 into M and share of Y equal to 3 by 4 into M. Share of Z equal to 5 by 6 into M. Adding all these values, we get the total 2500. Here we can see 1 by 2 equal to 0.5 and 3 by 4 equal to 0.75 and 5 by 6 equal to 0.833. So this is the maximum value and this is the minimum value. This is the share of X and share of Z. So here they are asked, what is the difference between the maximum share and the minimum share? So maximum share is given to Z and minimum share is given to X. So we have to find this value. Now let us find the value of M by solving this equation. 1 by 2M plus 3 by 4M plus 5 by 6M equal to 2500. Then in the denominator LCM 12, then 6M plus 3 into 3, 9M plus 5 into 2, 10M equal to 2500. Then 25M divided by 12 equal to 2500. M equal to, I'm taking this 12 right side, then it becomes 2500 into 12 divided by 25. This is equal to, here it become 100. 100 into 12, 1200. Value of M equal to 1200. Then value of Z equal to 5 by 6 into M. The share of Z equal to 5 by 6 into M. 5 by
6 into m, m equal to 1200. This is the share of z. 2, 6 are 12. 2 into 5 into 200, we get 1000. This is the share of z. Then share of x equal to 1 by 2 into m. 1 by 2 into 1200. This is equal to 600. Then difference between share of z and share of x equal to 1000 minus 600. We get our answer C for rupees 400. Question number 78. What is the value of n? The sum of the digits in number 10 raised to n plus 1 is 2. 10 raised to n plus 1 equal to 2. Then what is the value of n? That is what we have to find. 10 raised to n equal to 2 minus 1, 1. For any number power 0, then its value equal to 1. Here 10 raised to 0 equal to 1. So our answer is for n 0, n equal to 0 only. Then see the second option. This is our answer. See the second option. For any whole number, what is mean by whole number? Whole number means 0, 1, 2, 3, including 0, positive integers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If we are giving n equal to 1, then 10. 10 raised to 1 equal to 10. 10 plus 1, 11. So this is not our answer. Then for any positive integer, n only. Positive integer means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or we can say natural numbers. If you are giving n equal to 2, 10 square equal to 100, 100 plus 1, 101. For any real number n, that means minus infinity to positive infinity. That include this positive integer and whole number. We already proved that this is not satisfying this equation. Therefore, our answer is for n equal to 0 only. Question number 79. In a class, there are three groups A, B and C. If one student from group A and two students from group B are shifted to group C, then what happens to the average weight of the students of the class? So here, in a class, there are students, they are grouped into three. Then one student from group A and two students from group B are shifted to group C. Then what happens to the average weight? What is the average weight? Average weight is total weight of the students in the class divided by total number of students. Total students. Here we can see no student is going out of the class, or no new student is coming into the class. Therefore, total weight of the student is same all the time, and total number of the students also same. They are just interchanging the group. Therefore, the average weight will be same. Our answer is option C. It remains same. Question number 80. How many different sums can be formed with the denominations of rupees 50, rupees 100, rupees 200, rupees 500 and rupees 2000, taking at least three denominations at a time? So here we have to find how many different sums can be formed using the denomination, these five denominations, taking at least three denominations at a time. So
how many different ways we can select three denominations out of these five denominations, 5C3 ways. Then, at least three denominations. That means we can also have four denominations as well as five denominations. So, we can take four denominations out of this five in 5C4 ways and five denominations at a time in 5C5 ways. These are combination equations. Then, what is the value of NCR? NCR means N factorial divided by N minus R factorial into R factorial. Using this equation, we can solve this value. That is what our answer. This many ways, we can have different sums. 5C3 we can write as 5 factorial divided by 5 minus 3 factorial, that is equal to 2 factorial into 3 factorial plus 5C4, 5 factorial divided by 5 minus 4 factorial, 1 factorial into 4 factorial plus 5C5, 5 factorial divided by 5 minus 5, 0 factorial into 5 factorial. 5 factorial equal to 5 into 4 into 3 factorial divided by 2 factorial equal to 2 into 1 into 3 factorial plus 5 factorial divided by 1 factorial equal to 1 into 5 factorial we can write as 5 into 4 factorial. Then in denominator here it is 4 factorial plus 5 factorial, 0 factorial equal to 1 into 5 factorial. Simplifying this, we get our required answer. 3 factorial, 3 factorial cancelled, 4 factorial, 4 factorial cancelled, 5 factorial, 5 factorial here cancelled. Then 2 2's are 4. Then 5 into 2, 10, plus 5 plus 1, 16. In 16 ways, these 5 denominations, using these 5 denominations, we can have different sums taking at least 3. So our answer is option A, 16.